Hello guys, welcome to another FU Money. Today, Monday, the start of the week, 9th of August, and Bitcoin continues to go up as expected. So if you guys remember from the previous video, on Saturday I said that we probably would have a small retracement before breaking the trend line going up, the trend line for that bigger outlook I have. So the second part of the bull cycle, the white line. And now after the second try, Bitcoin is now going up and broke the trend line. So we expect a bit more of upside, but let's go to the chart. So here it is. We are going to start with the price to time model. Let me zoom in a bit so you guys can see it better. So here we are. It's the fourth week in a row that we have green candles, four green weeks. And right now on the log chart, at least we are above the 20 week SMA, the green line here. So regarding the price to time model, this is looking good. We are again above the 20 week SMA and the RSI is well above the orange dashed line down here. So that's it for the price to time model. We are still on time, on track to get Bitcoin to the top, at least close to the foreseen times or dates that we have been discussing for so long. But let's take a look at the crypto total. You guys remember that regarding the crypto total, I was, before we started this bull run up again, I was discussing the possibility of a retracement around 1.6. This happened around 1.66, so a bit later than predicted and a bit higher total than predicted too. But right now we had the first retracement and now we broke the trend channel, which is the red zigzag here. So guys, as expected, we broke the trend channel. We retraced to the top of the trend channel and we are now continuing the bull run up. So this movement up is going to continue. I am confident that this move up here on the total market cap is going to continue, and we are going to at least these levels here around the 2 trillion or a bit above, around the 2.15 trillion. So that's it, but don't forget, this is the dump zone. You guys know already my Fibonacci special Uber Elite Fibonacci display here on the screen, the green and red. And this is exactly the middle of that, which means that we are in the dump zone. So this is not the time to invest. This is the time to think about the plan for when we get here. So you should start thinking right now what to do when the total market cap reaches around 2.0 or 2.2 trillion, which is the mark when I'm expecting again a retracement or at least a local top for the total market cap. So this is the total market cap. And let's see the dominance. The dominance has been growing again. We are now 1% above, now 47% on dominance. And I'm expecting this to continue while Bitcoin is very, very bullish. Altcoins will follow, of course, but for now, Bitcoin is the first mover in the market. So we are starting to grow again on Bitcoin dominance. Right now, 47%. Just a few weeks ago, we were around 44 and now growing. So that's it for the Bitcoin dominance. Let's take a look at the chart on the MRI strategy. And here we are. Let me just turn off those plottings over there so you guys can see it better. Here it is, the monthly chart. We are still on a red count because, of course, due to this big drop here, we had a reset on the count and now we need to go above that level on this candle or the next candle will reset if continuing above the previous three and start a new count on the one green. So as we discussed many times, this was the reversal point around the 30,000 down here, which was also the same point of reversal on January when we had the first big retracement after the bull run started. So right now the chart looks very, very good. We are reversing the price action and we are about to reach the major resistances. So let's see how Bitcoin behaves there. But for now, the monthly chart looks good. All the moving averages are going up. We are still on a red 3 of 9, but this will change next month for sure, or even if this candle surpasses the previous big red candle here, which I don't believe we will be doing this month. But if we start a new month on the green, then this will reset the count and we will start a new count on the green with the number one, which is very, very good, because as you guys know, this means that we have a 1 to 9 count again, which will surpass for sure the previous all-time high. The RSI is not going sideways anymore. This is pointing up again towards the overbought zone. So be careful with this frontier here. If we cross this frontier, it means that we could be in for a correction. Also, the MACD was pointing down, going towards the orange line, but now the blue line is pointing up again, so they are becoming parallel, which means that the momentum for the bears is going away, is fading each day more. So that's it for the monthly chart. Let's take a look at the weekly. The weekly is the chart I like the most, and now we broke the 20-week SMA, not in log chart. This is the linear chart, so this is very, very good. We are now around $45,700, and we broke the 20-week SMA. This was a very, very important milestone for Bitcoin to show us that it wants to continue higher and recover all the lost ground in May when we had this big drop. So we are going to expect the moving average to start pointing up in a few more weeks for sure. This will start at 2 level, going sideways and then going up again. I'm not even expecting the 20-week SMA to cross below the 50-period SMA on the weekly. So if that happens, this is very, very bullish. We will continue up, and now we are facing resistances starting at 48,000, which are the support points for these candles here and these candles here. So we are now exactly breaking this one, which was support in February, and support in March, before we went up for the previous all-time high. Then we came back down and formed support again around the 48,000-49,000. And this is the next big resistance that Bitcoin will face before going for all-time highs. So expect a lot of resistance around 48,000-52,000. This is a $4,000 area, but this will be very, very hard to break. So we will have to wait and see what happens. The RSI on the weekly pointing up like crazy, but still a bit away from the overbought position here at the frontier around the 70 mark on the RSI chart. The MACD on the weekly is finally catching up. This is very important, guys. This MACD on the weekly is very important because now the blue line on the weekly will go above the orange line, and this will mark the start of the bull trend here. The bars will become green, light green, or even green if this continues at this pace, and the blue line will cross the orange, meaning that the weekly MACD will turn bullish. So this is a very important mark. It might start this week or even next week, but for this configuration here, this structure on the MACD right now, I believe that it will be this week that we will cross the line. That will be very, very good. Continuing. So that's the weekly chart. Let me just zoom out again. On the weekly chart, we are on a green 4 of 9. So this means that if this was a 1-to-4 candle correction on a bearish trend, this will be the point of no return if we go back down. So if we continue up for number 5, then this will continue up. So this is a very, very important moment right now. This is a, let me just show myself. This is a very important moment right now, because if we are able next week to continue with the green candles on the weekly, that means the 1-to-4 candle correction is not going to happen. Because if it had to happen, it would happen this week with that candle, or next week with the next candle becoming red and coming back down to break support. And when I say support right now on the weekly chart, I mean that this is now our support for the next move. So if we break this support, which is around 28.8 and 30,000, if this support is broken, we will get into a bear market, and that will be very, very bad. So we need this bull here, this bull run of the last 4 weeks to not be a 1-4 candle correction. We need this one to continue to a green 5 of 9 and continuing to go up and close the next candle above the previous candle so that we are sure that this is a new trend. So that's the weekly for you. The volume is still going a bit down on the weekly, average volume, of course, but I'm confident that this will continue up. At least the biggest probabilities are that we will continue to go up and close another weekly candle on the green, and then forming a new candle next week, which should also close on the green so that we don't have a 1-4 candle correction here on the bearish trend. So I expect this to be a bullish trend and to go for new all-time highs soon, but as you guys know, nothing is guaranteed in the market. So, of course, we still have to wait and evaluate what's going to happen next week. So let's take a look at the daily. And the daily looks very, very good. If this was to be a 1-4 candle correction on the weekly, this would be an ABC correction, Elliott wave. And then we would start to come back down and break all the supports, even below 28. Who knows, going to 20K again. But I am not expecting that. That's the very low probability. That's a very low probability of happening. So I'm expecting this to continue to go up and break the 48 resistance. That one will not be easy to break, but let's see what happens. It will probably take some time, but I'm expecting a correction soon. So probably when we cross the 48 or 49,000 line on the price action, I'm expecting probably a reversal of the price action for just a bit or some consolidation, and then retests, several retests of the 48-49 area to break above and go for new highs. So regarding the daily, this is already the fifth candle, so I'm not expecting a 1-4 candle correction here on this trend that was going down. I am expecting the continuation of this going higher, and let's see what happens. Right now it looks very, very good, and the bullish pressure to buy Bitcoin continues. So let's see how this evolves during the day and the next few days in this week. The RSI is now again overbought, so that's a concern, but I'm not expecting big moves right now. Bitcoin already went up 5% today. So you guys know that usually Bitcoin, when explodes up or down for some specific day, it usually is between the 5 and 10% move. So right now we are already at 5%. I'm not expecting bigger moves to the upside today, but I'm also not expecting a big correction because the buying pressure is very high. The MACD on the daily looks also very good. The blue line is above the orange and continues to go up. The bars are now again dark green, so that means the bullish momentum is gaining strength again. And that's a very, very good sign. Let's take a look at the 4-hour to see the BitMEX funding rate. The BitMEX funding rate is now going positive. So we are now around 0.03. And that, of course, is not very good for the bulls. But we had a small retracement already. So let's see how this goes. If we are to come back down and retest the 20-period SMA on the 4-hour, or if this is just a small retracement, as long as this is not below even half of the previous candle, I'm not worried. In fact, it could be a good opportunity to invest some money and have a buy opportunity as soon as we get out of this 45,000 area. So let's see how that goes. The RSI on the 4 hours is now coming out of the overbought area. The MACD is just going sideways and the lines are crossing each other several times. So this is neutral on the 4 hour. There's nothing to see here. Not very, very exciting chart. That's it for the MRI strategy. So this is the Pro Indicators framework. This is the, of course, you guys know already, this is the ranging channel, the big, big ranging channel since the bull run started, to distanciate from the green line that we'll see in the last chart. The green line, of course, is the bull line that has been supporting Bitcoin over time for 10 years. And this is very important. When we started to distanciate here in October 2020, it originated this big ranging channel, which is the parallel white lines. Now, we touched the bottom of that channel and we are now going up, but I'm expecting some the start of the resistance to start here around the 47,000 to the 51,000, 52,000. This will be a very, very resistant area to cross. So it will be very, very hard to break this. Also because this was support previously and it's really hard to break those supports when we come back down. So now we are going up and we are facing those supports as resistance. So I have already here the warnings of the indicator saying that this probably could be a reversal point, but let's see. We still don't have any signs here on the momentum, and we also don't have any triangles here on the chart. So there is nothing to do here. Just wait and see what happens. Don't forget, guys, this is the dump zone. You should not buy or sell. You should wait for Bitcoin to get up here to the resistance context. And probably if we have a bear signal, which is the red triangle, as you guys see here, we had one red triangle here just before the retracement. And if we get up there to the resistance context and we get a red triangle again, then this will be the time to take some profit and wait for the retracement to get over. So let's see what happens. Right now, there are no signs whatsoever. There is nothing to do. The buying opportunity was here. The sell opportunity or take profit opportunity will be around there. And this will be around the $51,000 or the 50 or 49. So around this area from 49 to 51, I'm expecting to have signals showing up, and let's see what happens. Even if this is the even if this red line here is crossed to the upside, that will for sure be a very, very high resistance area and take profit speculation, take profit area. So that's what you should look for. Let's take a look now at the Dixie, and the dollar is continuing up, which is not good. The dollar continues to show strength. I don't really understand. Maybe all the other coins in the world, all the fiat currencies in the world are showing bearish momentum. And that's why the dollar continues to go up, because this is relative from the dollar to all the other fiat coins in the world. But even with all the printing on the dollar, it shows no sign to want to go down and retest these levels here around an 89 and 90 on the Dixie, which was the previous support area. But this orange dashed line around here is big resistance. This was the previous swing high. So I'm not expecting the dollar to easily cross this line, but let's see how this evolves. I really would like to see the dollar retesting support down here around 90 or 89 and breaking it to the downside. But for now, it's not an easy task for sure, because we see the dollar going up. The only conclusion I can take is, again, probably all the other fiat currencies in the world are also losing strength facing the dollar or versus the dollar. And right now, that's the only reason why the dollar continues to go up on the Dixie. But I'm not expecting a crossover this orange dashed line. If that happens, then the dollar is really strong right now, and that's what we don't want. So that's it for the dollar. Gold. Gold continues to go down. It was being supported by the 200 SMA, the red line here, but now it's again starting to go down today. So let's see where this takes us. I still believe that this could be the low for the year, but we were already below that line, or exactly at the same line as this candle here, where it went when it was red. But I don't know what's happening with gold. Probably a lot of people are selling gold to buy Bitcoin, and that's also one of the reasons why Bitcoin has been going up for so many days in a row already. But gold was supposed to be higher to face or to be a hedge against the hyperinflation of the dollar. But right now, gold is losing strength, so Peter Schiff must be very, very angry. I really don't know what's happening with gold. This was supposed to hold the trend line here and then the 200 SMA, but all the supports are being broken, and I don't know where this will stop. But gold was really supported here by the MRI support line, the green dots. So let's see how that goes and evaluate in the next few days. But right now, I would not be very bullish gold. The S&P 500, we are now going down after an MRI top. So this is textbook maneuver here. the next candle after an MRI top usually reverses the price action, and we also have an A extension on the MRI, giving it even more strength to go down. So let's see if this is or not the real retracement of the price action in the S&P 500. I've been warning everyone about this in the last few videos, and this week could be the important week to focus on because of this reversal of the price action. So guys, keep your eyes on this. If you invest in the S&P 500, it's really important to keep your eyes here and see how the development of the week is going to occur. Okay, so the S&P is in a very, very delicate situation here. It could be the reversal of the price action to test at least a 20-week SMA. So keep an eye on that. If you are invested into the S&P, keep an eye on that. And let's see how this goes during the week. And for sure, the last chart of the analysis of today. Here it is. This is the very important moment I've been waiting for. We went to the trend line, as I was saying before. The white trend line shows the second part of the bull cycle here. So this is when we started to distantiate from the green line. The green line is the bull line, like the frontier between the bull market and the bear market. In my opinion, every time we are above this green line, we are still in a bull market. And this was the second phase of this cycle, which started to distantiate from the green line going up exponentially in October last year. And right now we had this white line as support. When we came down here, it supported the price several times until it was broken. But just after being broken, we got outside of this falling wedge and tested the trend line one time. And at the second try, we went above it, and we are now closing candles above it. So if we zoom here, you guys can see that we went above, continued up. We retraced a bit, this red candle there. It stopped exactly on top of the trend line, and we are now going up again. So we are now having this trend line again as support, and this is very, very important. So guys, I guess this was the analysis I had for you today. Let me just go here. The analysis of today was a bit broader. I went through all the charts, but as you guys know, the most important thing it was that we crossed the trend line. The white trend line for the second part of the bull cycle was crossed over to the upper side. We retraced, we made it support, and now we are again going up. So I guess this is a very good sign for Bitcoin in the next few days, in the coming days. And let's see how the week evolves. But of course, I will keep you guys informed all the time. So don't forget, if you enjoy this content, just gently touch the like button, subscribe to the channel, and of course, subscribe to the Telegram group. Also, join us in Telegram and come discuss Bitcoin, of course, with us 24 hours a day if you want. I will be there every time I can, if I'm not recording or sleeping. So I will be there for sure. I will take a look at almost all the messages that we get. So to do that, you just have to go to t.me/FUMoney on your browser, and that will take you to a page where you can join automatically. So don't forget, join us on Telegram, gently touch the like button here if you enjoy this content, and subscribe to the channel to support us and to grow the community. Okay, guys? So thank you very much for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Bye-bye.